So many viewers ask me questions about how to make their own topical vitamin C products. I'm not sure if it's because commercially available products tend to be fairly expensive, or maybe because oral forms of vitamin C are so readily available that it just seems logical you should be able to make your own serum. Today, I'll give you my take. Hello, I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and welcome to DermTV. Let's start exploring this topic with simply dissolving the crystals of vitamin C that are in this capsule and this tablet in water. So I'm going to take the capsule, I'm going to take it apart and dump its contents in the water, I'm going to stir it up, and I'm going to take one of the tablets, I'm going to put it in the water, I'm going to stir, and we're on our way to dissolving. If you put the resulting solution, that's dissolved vitamin C, on your skin, as soon as the water evaporates, the vitamin C that was dissolved in the water will recrystallize on your skin before it can be absorbed. Since crystallized vitamin C can't be absorbed into your skin, it can't work as an antioxidant. You see, you need a carrier to hold the vitamin C molecule in the solution so it can penetrate into your skin cells. If you have sufficient chemistry skills to grind up the vitamin C, so let's take 1,000 milligrams of vitamin C, put it in the mortar and with a pestle. We're going to grind this up until we have a nice fine powder, which you can see. And if you use a carrier like propylene glycol or glycerin, and you know how to calculate and measure the amount of ascorbic acid you need, you can then solubilize it and mix it properly. That, in theory, could yield a functioning topical vitamin C product. However, the problem here is that you're just going to have ascorbic acid, which is regular vitamin C, which is water-soluble, so it doesn't penetrate the lipid membranes of skin cells very well. Because it's acidic, it can be irritating when it's applied to your skin. And lastly, the acidic form is unstable because it's very quickly oxidized and thereby inactivated. For those reasons, if you're going to make a topical vitamin C product, you really want to use the ester form of vitamin C, not the acid form. The advantages to esters are, first, because they're fat-soluble, they much better penetrate the lipid barrier of your skin. Second, they're not acidic, so they tend to be much less irritating. And third, the fatty groups on the esters increase the stability of the vitamin C, so it's not as easily oxidized and inactivated. At the end of the day, when the vitamin C ester is absorbed into your skin, it then's changed back to regular ascorbic acid. So what you've done is, in a non-irritating fashion, you've affected better penetration at higher levels and maintained stability by using an esterified form of vitamin C. Creating this is beyond the scope of most amateur chemists. The final reason to not DIY vitamin C is that since it's so difficult to assess the efficacy of topical antioxidants, especially at home, by using a DIY vitamin C product, while they might feel nice, you could go on for months or years wasting your time with a product that doesn't work. So your takeaway today is, why take a chance on a product you don't know and miss out on the very valuable benefits available from professionally prepared topical antioxidants? Please join me again at DermTV.com. If you have a question, please send it to me by visiting DermTV.com/question. I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and thank you for watching today.